Section 4.1, ratios, rates, and unit rates. This video will help you write ratios, write rates and unit rates, and use unit rates for comparison shopping. So writing ratios, let's start with a definition. A ratio is a quotient that compares two quantities. Ratios usually are written in one of three ways. First is in words, and we would say that 3 to 7. We can write that shorthand with a colon, it's still read 3 to 7, and we can also write this as a fraction. Now normally as a fraction we would read this fraction as 3/7, but if we're talking about a ratio now, we would also read this the same way, 3 to 7. So one thing to note is that units do not need to be written in a ratio. Notice we just have numbers here, 3 to 7, 3 to 7, and 3 to 7. Later on in a second here, we're going to get into rates, and rates compare things that are different. So we need to make sure we write the units in a rate. But in a ratio, all we need are just the numbers. And so you already are probably familiar a little bit with ratios. So if you're shopping for a HDTV, the HDTV and most screens now, even computer screens do this as well, is they use a 16 to 9 ratio. And that describes the aspect ratio of the screen. So 16, this ratio, 16 here, and then 9 on the side. So the length is always longer than the width, which is 9. And so they just use this ratio, 16 to 9, and they scale it up to make a larger television, or they scale it down to make a smaller television. Let's take a look at some examples now to help you understand a ratio. Example 1, Terry's paycheck was $300 after taxes. If he paid $117 in taxes, what is the ratio of the taxes he paid to the amount of his paycheck after taxes? So write this ratio in three different forms. Okay, lots of stuff going on here. Let's see. So two important numbers here is that Terry's paycheck was $300 after taxes, and he paid $117 in taxes. And they want us to write the ratio of taxes he paid to the amount of his paycheck. So taxes he paid is 117, so that's coming first. So 117 to 300, that would be a way to write this. And I don't need to include the dollar signs here. Notice we're comparing dollars and dollars. So 117 to 300 is all I need. I can also write that with the colon. And I can also write that as a fraction. Now I would check always with a ratio. We want to make sure it's in simplest form, and all three of these ratios now are in simplest form. So that answer is good as it stands. Example 2. Write the ratio of 25 pounds to 20 pounds as a fraction in simplest form. Okay, so 25 pounds to 25 pounds. So I want to write 25 over 20. Notice we're comparing the same thing here, pounds and pounds, so I don't need those pounds there. 25 to 20, but now I want to simplify that. So I'm thinking a common factor of 5 will divide into each of these. So if I divide a 5 out of the top there, that would leave me with 5. And if I divide a 5 out of the bottom, that would leave me with 4. Now let's check to see if there are any more common factors. Nope. So that is as simplified as this ratio can get. Example 3. Write the ratio of 0.46 gallons to 0.7 gallons as a fraction in simplest form. Okay, so we're looking at 0.46 gallons over 0.7 gallons. And we want to write this as a fraction in simplest form. Well, fraction in simplest form does not have any decimals in it. So what we want to do is we want to clear these decimals out of the fraction to begin with. Notice up here I would need to move the decimal two places, down here just one. Well, what I need to do then is move them both two places. And the way I do that is I'm going to multiply. And I'm going to multiply by 100, because multiplying by 100 will move these decimals two places. Now whatever I do to the top of a fraction, do the same thing to the bottom of the fraction. So all it's going to do up top here then is move the decimal two places to the right. So that's going to give me 46. Down on the bottom, two places to the right is going to give me 70. Now I have this fraction, there's no more decimals in it, but now I want to go ahead and write this in simplest form. So I'm thinking right away these are both even numbers. So I'm going to cut them in half, divide a 2 out of each of these. So let's see, that would be 23 over 35. Now I check to see if there are any common factors in 23 and 35, and there are not. So that's my final answer, the fraction in simplest form there. Go ahead and pause your video player now and answer these practice questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, question 4. Jordan bought some fries for $2. and a soda for $1 at the cafeteria. Write the ratio of the money he spent on soda to fries in three forms. So we want to make sure we put the soda first, even though they were listed backwards up here. Notice this is telling us right here how we want these ratios written, soda to fries. So it's 1 to 2, 1 to 2, or 1 to 2 as a fraction. Question 5, write the ratio 24 pounds to 30 pounds as a fraction in simplest form. Okay, so that's 24 over 30, no units needed. Now I'm going to just look to divide some stuff out here. 2, they're both even, so I can start with a 2 there. That would give me 12 fifteenths. I could also now divide a 3 out of each of these. So when I divide a 3 out of the 12, I'll have 4 left. When I divide a 3 out of 15, I'll have 5 left. We could have also used factoring to simplify this. So if you used factoring, show you that real quick, we would have had 6, which is 2 times 3, times 4, which is 2 times 2. In the bottom, 30, I'm thinking 3 times 10, 3 times 10, which is 2 times 5. Divide out our common factors here, and you can see we get to the same spot, 4/5, using the factoring. So either way you did that was been fine. Okay, question 6. Write the ratio of 0.9 liters to 75 liters as a fraction in simplest form. So we got 0.9 up top, 75 in the denominator. Now, I want to clear out the decimals first. So here I just got to multiply by 10 to move that decimal one place. So let's see, that's going to give me 9 in the top and 750 in the bottom. Now I think 3 is probably going to go into these evenly. So when I divide a 3 out of 9, that will give me 3. And when I divide 750 by 3, that's going to give me 250. I just kind of thought of that as quarters. You know, 75 cents is 3 quarters. If I divide 3 quarters by 3, I'll get 25 cents. So that's kind of how I did that in my head. Writing rates and unitrates. Let's take a look at another couple definitions here. So a rate is a quotient that compares two quantities with different units. So very similar to a ratio, except now here we're looking at things that are different units. And so since the units are different, now we absolutely have to write what those units are in our rate to communicate what's going on or the things that we're comparing. A unit rate is a rate that has a denominator of 1. So any kind of rate where I get the denominator down to 1, then I have a unit rate. So rates are a common part of everyday life. You probably already have used rates to describe how fast you're traveling, miles per hour, how expensive things are, dollars per pound, and many other comparisons. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand how to write rates. So write a rate in simplest form for earning $100 in 12 hours. So now I want to make sure that I include the units here, okay? So $100 over 12 hours, I want to simplify that thing down. So let's see, first I start by cutting it in half, dividing a 2 out of each of those. So that would be 50 over 6 hours. I can simplify that again, cut it in half one more time. 25 over 3, and I think that's the best I can do. So there is my final simplified form there, $25 for 3 hours. Question 8, write a unit rate for driving 163 miles per hour for driving 163 miles using 5 gallons of gas. All right, let's start. We'll say 163 miles using 5 gallons. Okay, I want to get this down to a unit rate, meaning over here in the denominator, I want to have just 1 gallon. And that's always how a unit rate is, just one of the things in the denominator. So I want to make sure I divide everything out of that denominator. So I am going to divide both the top and the bottom by 5. So I want to divide the denominator by 5, and I'm doing that to get this down to 1 gallon. And then in a fraction, if I want to keep it equal, I got to make sure I divide a 5 out of the top. Now, that 5 is not going to go into 163 evenly, but that's okay. So this car, whatever car I was traveling here, gets 32.6 miles on every gallon, or 32.6 miles per gallon. And so this is usually how gas mileage is reported, because then you can easily compare one car to the next, you know. And that's the advantage of a unit rate. When we get things down to one one unit in the denominator, it makes comparing things very easily. So even though we got more of a complex fraction here where we have a decimal inside of a fraction, it's worth it here because when we get things down to a unit rate, it makes it really easy to compare stuff. Go ahead and pause your video player now and answer these practice questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. Question 9. Write a rate in simplest form for $150 in 20 hours. Okay, so $150 in 20 hours. We could factor this out, but I see right away that 10 is going to go into each of these numbers. And the way I know that is they both end in 0. If numbers end in 0, you can essentially just divide those out because that's just dividing both numerator and denominator by 10. And so it looks like that's going to be it here because I'm going to end up with $15 over 2 hours, and that can't be simplified anymore. All right, question 10. Write a unit rate for driving 134.4 miles using 4 gallons of gas. So 134.4, that's miles over 4 gallons. Now I'm headed for the unit rate here, 1 gallon is what I want. So I'm going to divide both the top and the bottom by 4. Denominator is easy, you know, 4 divided by 4 is 1, that's why we're picking 4. In the numerator, that gives us 33.6. miles per gallon. Use unit rates for comparison shopping. By comparing products with a unit rate, dollars per quantity, you can determine which product is a better buy. The unit rate, dollar per quantity, is often called the unit price. So to make a unit price calculation easier, write the fraction. To make unit price calculations easier, write it as a fraction. And so here we have our unit price, some number of dollars per one quantity. This is a good way to use a unit rate to comparison shop, is this unit price. Now let's take a look at an example that will help you understand how to use the unit price to compare products to see which is a better buy. So example 11, find the unit price and decide which product is a better buy. Round your answer to the hundredths place if necessary. In the hundredths place, that makes sense because that's our nearest cent. And then after that, how much will someone save per ounce if they purchase the better buy? Okay, well, let's take a look at A here. So we want dollars per quantity. This is what we're shooting for. Money per one, in this case, ounce is the way we want to set these up because our products here are measured in ounces. So I'm starting out with 26 cents for 12 ounces. And that's fluid ounces. I'll just use ounces for now and abbreviate that. And so what I want to head for now, since I want to write this as a unit price, is I want 1 ounce in the denominator, which means I am dividing top and bottom by 12. So let's see. Divide that top by 12. And we're rounding to the nearest hundredths place, the nearest cent, and that is 2 cents. 2 cents per ounce. Now, we don't want to put cents up here because this is a dollar sign. We wouldn't have 0.02 cents. That'd be a very small amount of money. We will still want to keep the dollar sign on there. So there is the unit price for product A. Product B, we're going to set it up the same way. Here we have $1.96 in money over 68 ounces. And we want to get this down to 1 ounce. So I'm dividing by 68, top and bottom. All right. So here now, 0.028, so that's 3 cents. So that is 3 cents per ounce for that bigger bottle. And so the smaller can was actually the better buy here. So we would say A is the better buy, and we can save 1 cent per ounce if we choose A. Go ahead now and pause your video player and answer practice question 12. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. Okay, question 12. Find the unit price and decide which product is a better buy. All right, so let's take a look. Product A, we're looking for a unit price. They're telling us 128 ounces for $4.25. So we want to put money on top for unit price, $4.25 for 128 ounces. Shooting again for 1 ounce in the denominator. So I'm dividing out that 128. Okay, when we do that, we find out that this one is 3 cents. 3 cents per ounce for product A. Product B, we've got 275 for 58 ounces. We want to divide that 58 out of there to get our denominator down to one. Let's see, what do we get? Of course, 1 ounce in the denominator. And 5 cents in the numerator. So, looks like A is the better buy here. So we would say A is the better buy. And we save 2 cents per ounce if we choose it.